Assalamu alaikum. Allahu, 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 Allah, Allahu, 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 Allah, Allahu, 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 Allah, Allahu, 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 Allah, Allahumma salli wa sallim ala Nabina Muhammad alayhi salam. Salatan tadumu wa tughna ilayhi ممر الليالي وطول الدوام اللهم صل وسلم على نبينا محمد عليه السلام صلاة تدوم وتغنى إليه ممر الليالي وطول النوام اللهم صلي وسلم على نبينا محمد عليه السلام صلاة تدوم وتغنى إليه ممر الليالي وطول الدوام
دوام يا رسول الله. We are trying our best to be in dawam. That's mean continue. Again, we are in very short period of time. For what? For our life. There is a bug, very small, tiny, maybe look like dust. It is have a life less than 24 hours. But for that bug, it is ages. For us also, maybe 100 years, it is ages. But for Allah Almighty, is nothing. That's why it is very important to use your time wisely. What wisely? At least when you see the reality, stuck with the reality. What is the reality? Reality is Allah Almighty, is Rasulullah, is Qur'an Kareem, and it is your Murshid. Murshid very important, because without Murshid, you don't understand Qur'an Kareem. Without Murshid, you don't understand Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Without Murshid, you don't understand Allah Almighty. Because that Murshid also, he was going through very hard road to be a Murshid. He was not born as a Murshid. Nobody will be born as a Murshid. That's why it's very important with the Irshad point. This Irshad point, it cannot be handled from father to son. It is not like royal things to be handled for somebody, it is your descendant. No, it should be that one. It is having the capacity and availability to be a Murshid, how they are giving it. For example, in olden days when Tariqa Naqshbandiya Aliya was going all around the global, it was not going from son from father to son. Maybe some case it's have father to son. This is no problem. But in other case, even so many murshid, they deliver it for somebody else. It's been having that secret. Been going for the Far East and then coming back for the Middle East and going to Africa and going to India and going all over. So if it has been from father to son, it should be local tariqah. But this is, it is wide international. Alhamdulillah, we are thinking about so many things happening around us, and we need to clarify, It's very important to clarify. If the Shaykh and the Murshid, he is clearly giving some maqam or something for somebody, that we all of us have to follow. Doesn't matter who he is. This is not the personality. It is the maqam that that person is sitting. Because with this one, he is handling so many things that we don't see. Yes. It is heavy things. It is not easy. Alhamdulillah, we are not in that maqam, but very happy to be out of it. Alhamdulillah, it being given to somebody, he is can carry it. And this is can carry everybody. Because to say, I am the one that I deserve this one, there is nothing called deserve. Normally, as a servant, we don't deserve nothing. Because it is only ata'un min Allah. This is being given from Allah Almighty. He is the one giving you. You cannot claim, I deserve to be like this. I deserve to be. I work so hard. No. You have to work. You go for West. If you don't work, you don't have bread. Say, you have to work. Why should I feed you? You have to work. Yahoo, I was trying to be relaxed. No, you cannot be relaxed. You have to work to deserve your food. We are, if Allah Almighty, He is giving us everything, we are not deserving, by the way. It is His generosity that He is giving and giving and giving and giving. So many gifts. In America, they have gift days, yes? In the gift days, they say, somebody send me some numbers of the turkey that they slaughter. It is about maybe 500 million turkey being slaughtered in Thanksgiving days. And they say, why you are making qurban in... Why you are making qurban in Eid al-Adha? Why? Oh, you are, this is animal and this is animal. But the turkey was never been holy animal, by the way. But the sheep and the goats, they been holy animal. All the prophet, they never been shepherd for turkey. Did you see any prophet having a thousand of turkey looking after them? No. Only. If he have this turkey, this prophet, he will never receive or deliver the prophecy because so many noise. So many noise around. Nobody will listen to that prophet. But Allah Almighty, He'd say, okay, you are go with goat or with sheep, so you will be the shepherd for. Sayyidina Ibrahim with his son, Ismail alayhi salam, there was having a lot of animal, so many, thousands, that like cannot count. And Jibreel alayhi salam, he say, Ya Rabbi, this Ibrahim Khalilullah, he is too much to dunya. Look how much animal he have. And Allah Almighty, He tell to Jibreel alayhi salam, go and test him. Okay, say. And Jibreel alayhi salam, he changed his looking and he was looking like a man. And he come to him, assalamu alaikum ya Khalilur Rahman. Alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Say, I want to take all your animals. I say, what shall I pay to buy them all? I say, you have to say, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Ibrahimu Rasulullah. I say, that's it. I say, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Ibrahim Rasulullah Khalilullah. My son, we are going. Okay, his son. Hey, wait. Say, wait. What? We make deal, we sell and buy. Khalas, finish. Say, no, I'm Jibreel alayhi salam. Too late. He say, it is all yours. We finish, we going. Freedom. I say, I was testing you that you will be attached to dunya or not. I say, okay. So what? I say, okay, I give you back. Say,
No.
Come, my son, we are going. I say, Ya Rabbi, what shall I do with this animals? I say, you have deal. And then Maulana Sheikh used to say that he have order to take all this behind mountain of Kaf. And he said this will be the potential for Mahdi alayhi salam time. Subhanallah. So that was the barakah of Khalilur Rahman. That's why this animals never finish. Because have the 124,000 Anbiya that they make dua to not finish the barakah of these animals. Everywhere you go, you find this animal. Even you go to Africa, you go to Far East, you go to Middle East, Pakistan, Hindistan, and anywhere, this is subhanallah. Plenty. And every day we are eating, never finish. This is barakah of Anbiya having on this animal. That's why Allah Almighty, when He create this animal, they say, what is our job? Say, you have very holy job to feed my servant. Subhanallah. And there is another thing that the West is scared about the food, and they say, oh, we have to get this pig. It is our food potential. But they say, in the analyze of the gene, yeah, of this animal, I don't like to make his name too much, it is have almost 90% of a human gene. Very near, very close by. And Allah Almighty say in His Qur'an, do you like to eat your brother meat when he is dead? Do you like to eat his flesh? No, nobody. And so how you eat this animal? Allah Almighty, if He prohibit it, it has have a reason for it. It is not a joke. I know this West, it is searching, making universities, Cambridge, Membridge, Tunbridge, Fungridge, Hungridge, so many kind of university, Islamic studying. Oh, you think this they study Islam? No, they are studying the holes to destroy Islam. And all the Muslim clapping. Ah! Oh, look this. Cambridge, Mumbridge, Dunridge, they are making Islamic institute to study Islam. How many people will come Islam in that studying? None. Zero. And you see all this Islamic country sending 100 million foundations, sending 100 million, I don't know what, sending I don't know how many 100 million for Islamic studying. Yahoo! You just go for the poor people that they are suffering. No. It's okay, they can suffer, no problem. But the studying is more important. For what? Oh, studying how to destroy Islam. Studying how to make this Muslim more stupid. Studying how to make this Muslim to be idiot. Studying how this Muslim to be not knowing nothing. This is reality. When you say reality, oh, you are a weird one. You don't understand. No, we understand. Alhamdulillah. The Murshid make you to understand. The Murshid, he tell you in advance. The Murshid telling you what will happen in advance. Very important to realize what the Murshid is giving. Yes. The Murshid don't think he is only say, La ilaha illallah. No. That's the Murshid. He gave you ocean of knowledge. You will be advanced. Imagine when they have the Islamic empires once upon a time, every sultan or every emperor, he have his Murshid next to him. Say, oh my Murshid, I will take decision like this. He will tell him, don't take this decision, it is wrong. It is very wrong to take such a decision. And the sultan or the emperor, he will think about it and say, okay, I will follow whatever you say. When Sultan Mehmed Al-Fatih, that the conqueror to Istanbul, his murshid, he gave him very big map, what to do. And he tell him, when you find difficulty, you open that map and how to conquer Istanbul. Huh? If you are okay without it, when you finish the conquering, you open it and see what is the plan. This is historical, true story. It is not
legend.
It is not a legend. It is a true story. Because the history, it's have a lot of legend. So many people, they say, oh, history. Oh, you can make stories about history. But this one is true. And alhamdulillah, Fatih conquered Istanbul in a few months and he take everything and he went inside. When he went inside, his murshid come and he say, did you open the plan? He said, no, my murshid, I was going according to my heart. What my heart telling me, I was doing until we conquer, alhamdulillah. And then now he say, okay, open the plan to see what I was written for you. What I was writing for you. And when they open it, and it was exactly what his murshid was telling him. Exactly, 100%. You have to attack from here. You have to make the ship to go from the land and to be. And he say, alhamdulillah. Sultan Fatih, he was saying, everybody coming to my prison, his feet shaking from the fear because he was so strong and having manifestation that nobody can stand in front of him. I say, when I go to my murshid, my feet is shaking. I don't know what's happening to me. This is the power, the spiritual power. It is the most important things. Today, they take all this spiritual power from the people. They taking it out with the studies of Kambrish, Mambrish, Tanrish. This is very important things to wake up. But still deep sleep. This wake up will be only in Mahdi alayhi salam time. But our duty at least to say, we know, we know. Maybe you do, but we still we know. Alhamdulillah, Allah Almighty, He put in our heart the real wake up, because we have a Murshid that make us to wake up. Otherwise, we will be also sleeping, deeply sleeping, going on and on and on and on. Alhamdulillah, we are here, at least we are in service of Ibad to make them wake up. This is how much we can do. At least if we are doing well, that will make us in better situation in front of Allah Almighty. That's why don't be lazy to do your khidmah, to be the one servicing of Ummah, because this is also important that we keep up going for people and making people to wake up and to understand. Very important. May Allah bless you and make us happy here and hereafter, and to make our service accepted in divine presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and in divine presence of Mashayikh al-Izam, that they say, we are proud about our children, how they are doing their duty. May Allah forgive me and forgive us and make us in the mercy of Allah Almighty and with the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Wa min Allah at-tawfiq bi hurmati al-habib bi hurmati al-fatiha.